In this video, I'm going to just give you a few understandings from my experience of using both of these method of installing biodigesters, and then just give you a basic understanding of it so that you can also decide for yourself, either you're an installer or you're a homeowner, which one you should adopt. When we started this business about 6-7 years ago, it was blogs that we were taught how to use to install biodigesters, and then that's how we started the business. But with time, when business was booming, and then the industry was picking up, engineers were adapting the technology, and then the team decided that precast slabs would be a better option in terms of the turnaround time and then the number of digesters that you can install in a day when you are using precast slabs. All you need to do is to show up on site, and then within 1 or 2 hours, your job is done, all things being equal. So it became a game changer, because then we could install a lot of digesters in a day. That's why we adopted the technology. New installers or people who want to install biodigesters, homeowners, and they want to know what's the difference and what are the advantages of using either one of these two. Now, the background to blogs is that it works best when you are new to this biodigester business, because what it means is that you have set up your business, and then as an installer, you are looking for a way whereby you will maximize your effort. So what is available is what you use. What we say is, with biodigesters, you use whatever is available in the environment to do them. You don't need to stress too much. You don't need to worry yourself about the materials that you are going to use. So blog is readily available and it's easy to use. They know this mindset of using blogs in construction. So if you are new to this technology, then your obvious choice will be to use the blogs. And then that's why most of us started using blogs. But then blogs have a bit of advantage when it comes to digesters, mainly in certain areas or certain conditions or in certain situations. The soil cap that you are going to meet will determine the type of materials that you should use. If you go to a place and then it's salty or it's waterlogged, it's clay, and the water does actually take a long time before you can seep into the ground or the earth surface, then your best bet is to use the quarry dust blocks. The experience is coming from the fact that if you go to a salty place, if you use precast slabs, then a time will come, it will just crack it and it will break it, or it will just to affect the shape and size of the digester. So then it's best to use blocks in such situation. Blocks are also important when you are doing your work in a waterlogged area where there's going to be a lot of water in the ground. Probably there's going to be a lot of water also in the soak hole, which is going to take a lot of time for it before it goes away. So then that's where the idea of using blocks actually comes in handy. But mainly from my experience, those who do the block works or those who use the block works are the new installers who are also not that good at the business and are learning, and then certain situations are supposed to use block. So in my situation, if I travel outside Accra, wherever I'm working, and then I can't get the precast slabs, then I readily use blocks in those areas. So if I travel outside Accra, then my best bet is to use the blocks. Now, come to think of it, if you are an installer and you're in this business, your business model should be based on the fact that, well, how many digesters can you install in a week? Let's not even talk about day, in a week or in a month. So if your business mindset is that, or you have jobs and you are supposed to do, and you're using blocks, then you have to cast the top slab. You have to wait 2 or 3 days for it to dry. And then you also have to lay your blocks and wait for it to be firm enough before you can do the inside bed and then laying of the filtration materials and all those stuff. And then you have to take the top cover and cover it before you can go. So mostly that one will take you 2 or 3 days before it's done. But if you're using the slabs, just within a day or less than 4 or 5 hours time, you have finished your digesters and then you are gone. So basically, that's the advantage when it comes to the precast slabs. Some people have also argued who do not trust the slabs, because then they think that the slabs are not going to last well. But if a slab is done well, it must contain wire mesh, it must have the quarter rods or iron rod in it, the crates possibly. It must have all the ingredients, and it must use quarry dust, and of course only cement to have it cast. That one, it becomes firm, and then it should be 2 inches or maybe 2.5 inches, and you are not going to have any problems when you do that. The only problem is if it's not installed well and there are some holes around it and then water is seeping through. But the idea of biodigesters is that you should not allow water to be retained in the digester. if you are using precast slabs, it shouldn't be a problem. Unless, like I said earlier, the place is salty, and then with time, it might just affect the size and shape of the biodigester or the slabs. Apart from that, slabs work best. They work well in all situations, and it's not going to be a problem. So in my estimation, precast slabs works best, one, when you are an installer, and two, if you require a small space to install a biodigester. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you are new to this channel, subscribe for videos that explains how these biodegradable biodigesters work and how you can use it to manage your toilet wastewater system. In some cases, we've gone to houses whereby it's a half plot or it's a full plot, but the owner wants to maximize the land. So they give you 3 feet at the back of the house, and then they ask if you can do a biodigester there. In that situation, if you are using that space, then obviously blocks will not work in that situation. That's where the precast slabs come in handy. So the other truth is that the thin nature of precast slabs do not make them less strong than blocks. If done well, precast slabs that contain your quarry dust, your wire mesh, your binding wire, and then your quarter rod or 3/8 iron rods will work as well as a block that has been used in biodigester installation. The advantages of both slabs and blocks are not that much different. In any situation, it can be used. I've used slabs in commercial jobs. I've used slabs in domestic work, and I've used blocks in commercial work, and I've used blocks in domestic work, and I do not see any difference between them.